Astrid.
The Joker. Seems about right. Feels like another record cold. Feels like another record cold snap on the way. I'd better get a fire going before the pipes freeze up again. Great Bear Island. Dad used to fly there all the time. He said it used to be beautiful. Not much reason to go there these days, since the quakes and all. Ah, a rare McKenzie family photo. Miss you, Dad. Well, here we are, old girl. Your best flights may be behind you, but you're still beautiful to me. And anyways, you're all I've got. I'd sure love to give you one last great adventure. Cheap electric crap. Never works when you need it. Damn, I was right. Pipes froze up again. Getting pretty late in the day. Guess I could take a nap. I don't remember needing my parka this early in the season. It seems to get colder every year. Could that be? Turned out pretty well. Jackrabbit Remote Transport, McKenzie speaking.
I told her not to come up. I told her you couldn't fly in this weather. For once, we do not need no damn...
Well, slow down, Marie. What are you talking about?
She just showed up. Said you'd see her. Said you'd fly her north. I know you need the money. The weather service...
It's okay, Marie. I've got it from here.
Hello, Will.
What are you doing here?
It's been a while, I know.
Yeah. Years. I haven't heard from you since...
I know. And I wouldn't be here if it weren't important.
Well, what brings you... I mean, are you sick?
No, not me. But I need to get to someone who is.
Right. So you're still a doctor?
Yes, I'm still a doctor.
I thought that after... Why are you here?
I need your help. There's an isolated community in the northern part of Great Bear. Someone there is very sick.
Great Bear? There's nothing there anymore. Not since...
I know. But I have to get there.
Still trying to save the world, huh?
Somebody has to.
What's that supposed to mean?
McKenzie, Will, I didn't come here to fight about the past. I need a pilot to take me somewhere remote. Someone who won't ask too many questions. Someone I can trust.
Wait, questions? Astrid, are you in trouble?
Are you going to help me or not?
What's in the case?
See, there's that thing about no questions, remember?
What's in the case, Astrid?
No questions.
Look, the weather out there is bad. Bad. When it's getting worse. You walk in here after years. I could have been dead. You could have been. And then you show up and you want me to just risk my life flying into the middle of the great northern nowhere to deliver you in some mystery metal case to some remote wilderness outpost. All because you walked in here and asked me to?
Yes.
Astrid, you can't bring him back.
This isn't about that.
I know how hard it's been.
No. You don't know, McKenzie. You don't know anything.
You don't think I feel it too?
Are you gonna take me or not? The longer I wait, the worse it'll get. Damn it. I don't have time for this.
Wait. The worse what will get? Why do I have a feeling you're not talking about the weather?
Because I'm not.
Throw your bags in the plane. I'll get started on pre-flight. Better buckle up tight, because it's going to be a rough ride. Let's see. Two people plus enough fuel to get us out to Great Bear and back leaves. Almost no capacity for cargo. If we're too heavy, we'll burn through our fuel before we get there. I'll have to be careful about what else I take with me. distress pistol. Water, energy bar. Astrid's a doctor, so we're covered there. But probably best to have some extra meds just in case. Astrid, the mysterious case. Astrid definitely doesn't want to talk about what's inside. Which means he's probably not supposed to have it. Need to grab my parka and we can go.
You're still wearing it.
Huh? Wearing what?
Your ring. Our ring.
Oh. Yeah. I mean, I just forgot to take it off.
I wear mine too.
Why?
Memories, I guess.
I thought you wanted to forget.
Not all of it.
Look. I should have looked for you.
It's okay. I've kept busy. I've moved on.
You sure? Because this all seems pretty familiar. You still working with that researcher, Dr. What's his name?
No. No, I'm not working at the center anymore.
Well, then where?
I'm working on my own. Freelance, you could say.
Freelance doctor? That sounds legit.
I don't question your life choices, Mackenzie. Plenty of things you could be doing besides hanging out in your dad's old plane and drinking in the daytime.
Hey, we had a lot of good times in this plane. And it's under control.
I know, okay? I'm not here to fight, really.
I think about him all the time, you know?
I know you do.
But I did. The choice I made. I did it for us.
You don't have to. Let's just not...
No. It's important that you hear this. There's things I need to
Mackenzie,
say.
Mackenzie, not now. There's...
Just let me tell you.
Will, shut up for a second. Something's wrong.
That is not good.
What's going on?
Power's gone. The whole electrical system looks fried.
Shit! What's happening?
No power means we're going down. Hold tight.
Will?
Astrid. Astrid! I must have gone right through the windshield. Trees broke my fall. Oh, mostly.
Need some first aid.
Smart.
We need to find some place to escape this cold. Could probably climb that.
Yeah.
Damn. Arm's too weak. I don't feel so good. I need to rest up.
Astrid hasn't come looking for me. Which means she can't come looking for me. Because she's hurt. Or worse. I'd better get back up to the crash site. I don't feel so good. I need to rest up.
Ah, damn, that smarts. Serious? Come on. Come on. It worked. Astrid hasn't come looking for me. Which means she can't come looking for me. Because she's hurt. Or worse. I'd better get back up to the crash site.
I could probably climb that.
I'll die if I don't warm up soon.
Anything right about now. I think I'm gonna make it. Tongue feels like sandpaper. Finally made it. plane. Not sure which of us looks worse. Poor girl. This isn't how things were supposed to end. I've been looking for you. Astrid's back. Just what I need. Locked. Whatever's in this case, Astrid was ready to die for it. I hope she hasn't already died for it. Fire's life out here. Huh.
Damn it. She definitely passed through here. And in a hurry. Astrid, where did you go? Oh, is that a wolf? I'd better keep my distance. Like some kind of radio tower. I must be closer to civilization than I thought. Someone's just sitting here, frozen.
Great. A town. Maybe I should find help there. Look, smoke from that chimney. That means someone's home.
Hello? Anyone out there?
This whole area looks like it's been abandoned for a while. What happened here?
Hello? Anybody here?
Hey. Hey, wake up.
Holy shit! Wait! Hold your fire!
Get back.
Okay. Just take it easy.
Why are you here?
I saw the smoke from your chimney.
Outsider.
What?
Thought so. Mainlander. Outsider. I don't recognize your voice. And you haven't left like the others. So, must be a mainlander. Someone who doesn't know any better.
My plane, I crashed in the mountains nearby. I'm looking for someone who crashed with me. A friend. She might be injured.
I haven't seen her.
Listen, could you maybe point that gun someplace else?
You think because my eyes are covered, I can't see you? Make the wrong move, say the wrong thing. You'll see how good a shot I am.
I don't doubt it.
The others are all gone. If you are here, things must be worse than they thought.
Name's Mackenzie, by the way. And you are?
I had a name once. But for years, the townsfolk have called me Grey Mother. A name takes on its own life. Such that at one point, the name becomes the thing it belongs to. Then the old names fade. Can only be remembered by the young and the true.
So, I should call you...
You should call me Grey Mother also.
Sitting here with a rifle in your hand. You expecting trouble?
Trouble? Trouble found me.
You mean the storm?
The bad men. The bad men came. Took my things. Tried to take my house. They thought they were safe, because Grey Mother can't see. They were wrong.
Who are the bad men?
The men they passed through town. The night of the storm. The night of the lights.
I'm looking for my friend. She crashed with me when my plane came down in the mountains. Do you think she could have come through and been caught by these bad men?
I can't say for sure. Is your friend a survivor?
Yes. She is.
Then there is always hope.
The bad men, did they try to hurt you?
Everyone thinks being old means you're weak. But they underestimated Grey Mother.
It seems they did. I crashed without much food or gear myself. And if these bad men cleaned you out, we're gonna need to find some food and fuel, or neither of us is gonna make it through the next few days. You have any idea where we could find some supplies?
The bad men took everything. And the others in town who would have helped me are gone. The ones left will have their own worries. It's up to you, Outsider.
I'll do what I can, but I'll need your help. There must be somewhere in town to get food, fuel, the essentials.
What about your friend? Aren't you in a hurry to find her?
Yes, I am. And I'll be looking for signs of her. But there's a lot of ground to cover. And without gear, I won't make it. So while I'm looking for supplies, you see what you can remember about the Night of the Lights, and if she might have passed through town.
That way, maybe we can help each other.
Okay. Outsider. Greymother can't promise she can unlock the secrets in the dark cupboards of her mind. But she'll try.